Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie Vio, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. About a month ago, I released a tutorial teaching you how you can make money with a small YouTube channel of under 5,000 subscribers. I am making money every month with ad revenue with my two different YouTube channels, this YouTube channel and also my Sparkle English YouTube channel. If you have any passions or interests, I really encourage you to start a YouTube channel because if you can eventually build it up over time, you can be making a small passive income with your YouTube channel. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about setting up your own YouTube channel. I'm going to show you how to create a channel, how to name your channel, how to upload your brand profile picture, your channel cover art, your watermark, and adjust all the different settings that you need in order to have your YouTube channel ready to be published. I'm also going to show you how to use Canva to create your own channel cover art and give you a quick demonstration of how Canva can help you out with that as well. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. In the near future, I will be uploading more tutorials on how to become a YouTuber and how to make money with YouTube, so make sure to subscribe to my channel so you can stay tuned and see those videos. So let's get started. So the first thing you need to do is go to youtube.com and sign in. Now you have to sign in using your Google or Gmail account, and if you don't have one, you can easily create one. And once you're signed into YouTube, just click on the profile icon on the top right, so in my case, this little J icon, and then from here, you're going to click Create a Channel. Now it will say your creator journey begins, and you just have to click Get Started. Now you can choose how to create your channel. You can use your name, which means creating a channel using the name and picture on your Google account. So for example, my channel, I just have it as Jennifer Marie. But you can also choose a custom name and create a channel using a brand or other name and picture. Now, the benefit of doing this is that sometimes one of the best ways to gain subscribers or followers to your channel is to comment on other related videos. So let's say, for example, you have a fitness channel and your channel name is, you know, Fitness Tips. Then when you comment on other fitness videos, people will see your name as being Fitness Tips and they may click on your channel to see what your content is like. And if they like it, they can subscribe. So it's definitely something I recommend considering doing. So either click Select under Use Your Name or use a custom name and choose Select. So here we're going to create your channel name. You can use your brand's name or another name. A good channel name represents you and your content. You can change your channel name at any time. So for this example, we're going to call this Get Fit with Jeannie. Then click I understand that I am creating a new Google account with its own settings, including YouTube search and watch history. And then choose Create. Okay, so nice work. Your channel Get Fit with Jeannie has been created. Now follow the steps to complete your channel. So the first thing we're going to do is upload a profile picture. At the bottom here, it says we recommend a square or round picture that's 800 by 800 pixels. Use a PNG, JPEG file, no animations. So if you need help creating your profile picture that's 800 by 800 pixels, you can just go ahead, open up Canva, choose Create a Design, type in 800 by 800, then create new design again, and you can use Canva for free. I have a link in the description below that you can choose to access and get Canva. Then from here, I'm going to go to uploads, click on upload from device, and then I'm going to choose the profile picture I'm going to use. So let's say this is, you know, Jeannie boxing, and I want to use that as my profile picture. Then you can just click and expand it so it fits the 800 by 800 square image. You can add any effects if you want as well. Then click download and then download. Now we're gonna go back, click on upload picture and upload the 800 by 800 pixel picture. Okay, so now we have a chance to tell viewers about your channel, let viewers know what or whom your videos are about. Your description can show up in search results and other places. So you have 1,000 characters to describe your channel. I recommend trying to fill out as much information you can about your channel using all the relevant keywords. So if your channel is about gaming, then make sure to, you know, talk about what kinds of videos people will see. For example, Get Fit with Jeannie is a YouTube channel where you'll learn tips and tricks on how to get in the best shape of your life. This channel features videos about how to make healthy recipes and food, fitness tips, exercise demonstrations, and more. Subscribe to Get Fit with Jeannie to get in the best shape of your life in 2021. So if this was a real channel I was working on, I would write even more to fill up the 1,000 characters using more relevant keywords about my channel. Now you have an option to add links to your sites. So you can put in your website if you have a website. You can also put in a Facebook page or Twitter or Instagram handle, and all of these links will pop up in the banner so that when people are checking out your channel, they can also subscribe to you. For example, I have a Facebook page and an Instagram page, and I don't really promote them in too many spots, but I have them linked on my banner in my channel, and people are always finding me and or liking my page or my Facebook page or my Instagram page because they're clicking on those links. So it is important to have these connected as well. If you're just starting out and you don't currently have a website or any social profiles, don't worry, you can add all of these later on. So here you would just put in your URL and then you can put save and continue, or you could just click set up later. That's okay. Okay, so this is what our channel looks like right now. So you can see they've just added the profile picture that we added. And now we need to add some channel cover art and do a few other things. And here we're going to click on basic info. So here you can see we have our channel name and description, and you can choose the pencil icon if you want to make any edits. We have the channel URL, and then at the bottom, links, so you can add links to sites you want to share with your viewers. So let's say we wanted to change this, click on the pencil icon and you can change your channel name and then click publish if you want to make any edits to your channel name and description. Now let's go back to branding. So you can see we have our profile picture and then we have a spot for banner image. So it shows you that for the best results on all devices, use an image that's at least 2048 by 1152 pixels and 6 megabytes or less. So you can click on upload to upload your banner image. Now YouTube is a little bit more difficult to make a banner image. It's really easy to do it with Facebook or other websites like that, but YouTube is a little bit more complicated because it will look different depending on what device you're on. So I recommend going to Canva and using one of their templates. Again, you can join Canva under my referral link by clicking on the link in the description below. So once you're on Canva, you can type in YouTube channel art. Canva has a free option and also a pro option. There are plenty of templates that are both free to use and pro ones depending on whether or not you have a pro membership. So you can choose create a blank YouTube channel art, or you can choose one of these templates and you can customize it completely. Let's say you want to make one that has a certain color. Let's say your brand color is red. You can go to color and then click on the color wheel and choose any color that's related to your brand colors and then apply. So you can see here all these different ones have popped up. Let's say I like this red one right here. I'm going to click on that and then choose use this template. And then here you can just click on any elements you don't want to use and delete them or edit them. So I'm going to add in my own name. Let's say I'm going to put my channel name, Get Fit with Jeannie. Click on uploads, upload a picture, click and drag and make any sort of edits you want to this. I will be creating a detailed tutorial on how to make channel art. This video is just to quickly show you that you can do this with Canva. You can add any graphics or any elements that you want as well, any text. So I recommend looking at other channels that are similar to the type of channel you want to create to get some ideas for what you should put on your channel art cover. You want it to look cool, you want it to look professional so people will subscribe to your channel. Okay, so let's say I'm happy with this. I'm going to download it. Just click on download and then download again. And then here we have our channel art. When we go back to YouTube Studio and click on upload, you can see here they're showing us what it will look like on a computer, on a TV. So you can see here Viewable on TV will be the entire image if someone's watching YouTube on their television. And then viewable on desktop, that would just mean this small bar here is what people are seeing on the desktop. So for example, I want to make some edits to this because, you know, you can just see her chest on the desktop and I want you to be able to see her face. So let's say I'm going to make some edits and then re-upload. And then in this little box here is viewable on all devices. So get fit with Jeannie, exercise, healthy eating, and meditation. That would all be viewable to people watching this channel on their mobile phones as well. So that's perfectly fine. So if I click done to upload the image and then go back to my channel, you can see here, this is what it would look like. So I want to make some edits so her face is there. Okay, so now I've just changed it within Canva again. Canva automatically will save your channel art under your designs. And then I've just clicked change and re-uploaded the banner image, and now it looks great. Okay, so now we have a spot for a video watermark. So the watermark will appear on your videos in the right-hand corner of the video player. Adding a video watermark is a great idea because otherwise people can, you know, steal your content and re-upload it on YouTube. And this is a great way to sort of make everyone know that you created this content by putting your own logo there. So you need to put a 150 by 150 pixels is recommended. So let's say you have a logo. I like to use PicMonkey because you can make a transparent background. And let's just say, you know, this here was my logo, Get Fit with Jeannie. Again, I will be showing you how to do this in detail in a future tutorial. I just want to show you what sort of things you can add to your YouTube channel. Download this, and then you can upload your little logo. And then here, under display time, you can either choose for the watermark to appear at the end of the video, at a custom start time, or during the entire video, depending on your preference. After that, you can just click publish. So now let's click go to channel. And now you can see here, we have a really nice channel. We've got our profile image. We have our banner and everything is visible. Now we're going to click on customize channel. And we're going to click on basic info. And let's say afterwards, now you've created a Facebook or an Instagram. You can go ahead here and add in any links that you want. Under links on banner, choose however many links you want to show up on the banner. I recommend doing all of them, and that way people will have more access to all of your different links and can connect with you on all of your different links, whether that's your website or your social media. You can also put in a contact email address in case people want to contact you with business inquiries. Make sure to click publish. And then here you can see that they have Get Fit with Jeannie, so your website's name. And then the Facebook icon and Twitter and Instagram will automatically pop up once you put in your Facebook URL. So going back to customize channel, and we're going to click on settings and then click channel. And here you can put your country of residence, choose the country where you're currently based. And then you can also choose all the different keywords for your channel. So if you have a fitness and health channel, again, fitness, health, health and fitness, lose weight. Put in as many keywords as you can that are all related to your channel. Then go to advanced settings, and here you could put in your audience. So every time I publish a video, you know, it'll ask me, is my video meant for children? So if you want to avoid having to answer this each time, you can just set it that no, this channel is not made for kids. I never upload content that's made for kids. Or yes, this channel is made for kids. So be careful with this. Only choose that your channel is made for kids if it's actually made for children. Or you could just click, I want to review this setting for every video. Here you can scroll down and then you can choose whether or not you want to display the subscriber count. So let's say you don't want people to know that you've just started out and you have zero subscribers or one subscriber. So you can click this. Right now it's activated so people can see how many subscribers I have to this channel, but you could disable it if you don't want people to know, you know, in case you are worried that they won't subscribe to your channel if you don't have many subscribers. Now we're going to choose feature eligibility. See how to gain access to the features you're interested in below.
So right now we want to enable phone verification because that way we can publish videos over 15 minutes and add custom thumbnails. So in order to do that, just click on it and then you're going to have to verify your phone number, and that way you'll be able to add custom thumbnails, and that is important when you're wanting people to view your YouTube channel. So go ahead and verify your phone number. And after that, it should say phone number verified. They'll send you a verification code. You'll see that it's now enabled, all those features. So we can go ahead and click save. And that's pretty much it for setting up your channel. In my next video, I'm going to show you how to add a channel trailer for people who haven't subscribed and how to upload videos and do all of that stuff. But right now, this is all you need to do to get started just setting up your channel. And I recommend going through each of these steps and filling it out completely before you start adding videos to your channel. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys like this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. I will be walking you through how to do everything with regards to YouTube, how to edit videos, how to upload videos, how to fill out and do some keyword SEO so you can attract more viewers to your videos as well. If you like this video, please click like, it really does help me out. And if you guys have any comments or any requests on what types of videos you want me to create based on YouTube, make sure to drop a comment in the comment section below. Thank you guys once again for watching, and I will see you in my next video.